Now that we have our base CAP application that's been generated for us using Joule, we've added authentication, we've built other capabilities, we want to connect to our S4 system that we're going to extend and use a service from S4 in our application. To do that, we're going to add an external service. And this is going to bring up the service center where we can go to the Business Accelerator Hub or view the connections that we've set up for our particular environment. I'm going to go here and I'm going to choose S4HANA Public Cloud. That's the system that I'm going to connect to. And then from there, I narrow down the search to sales because I want to pull in sales order information. I can view all the entities. I can even preview the data from here. I can see the properties on a particular entity, the diagram of the entity. And I know that this is the content that I want to see. So I can just add this to my project. And now it's going to show up as an external resource in the storyboard. You can see the sales order A2X. I can view the diagram of the content. And here we can see all the entities and their properties again, very much like we saw it in the Service Center Explorer. Now I return to the storyboard and I have my external resource, but now I need to expose that through my service interface in my CAP application. And to do that, I want to open the service definition in the graphical modeler. And now I want to add a projection on that external resource. That's going to add the entity of the external resource to my service interface. So I don't need draft enablement, but I can come here and I see all the entities that are part of my external service. And I'm going to take just the base sales order. And by default, it adds all the properties, but I'm going to choose just a few of them that I need in my particular extension application. I could also rename these properties at this point as well. You see the little pencil next to the field name that would allow me to create an external name that's different than the name of the service. But I'm going to keep it one-to-one for now. The names all work for me. I'll accept that. And now that is embedded in my service.